What's up, guys? Jay back with another view. Three P today, three videos. This is gonna be an interesting one because everyone has their own thoughts and opinions on what's like the great their greatest hoop shoe ever. But honestly, I don't give a F. This one is no debate, no discussion, period. I just don't wanna even argue it. There's just no debate on it. You know, people here and there are going to say, like, oh, no, it's the Kobe 4. That's the greatest hoop shoe ever because it's the first low top and it popularized low tops. It's okay. It's all right. To me personally, it's not top five. Or there's other people that's going to say, oh, it's the Kobe 5. The Kobe 5 has the best fit ever. It's so one-to-one. It's a glove fit. And also the materials on it, the traction was great. And the zoom bag on the forefoot and the heel and the great lockdown from the heel cup. It's best ever. It's all right. It's almost up there. Top five for sure. Or people that go to straight up with the six. Oh, greatest. This was the greatest. Oh, because of the materials. The upper was great. It was so soft and it's so durable because the scales on it, it mimicked the Black Mamba, and it did provide great performance. Also, the lightweight midsole, because it was a Phylon midsole, it was so, like, it felt like pillows. And the suction traction, it was like an octopus, the tentacles, it stuck to the floor. It's great. This one's definitely almost definitely top five. Or they're gonna hate on this one and say, like, this one it's nowhere up there when it should be. This one was a great performing one when broken in correctly. So getting down to my main point, by the look of this box, everyone should know what this one is. This is the greatest, my opinion, the greatest hoop shoe ever. No argument, no debate. I don't want to hear anything, any counter arguments, like, oh, the Jordan 34, Jordan 36. Nope. Nothing will ever beat this sneaker. Nothing at all. Here you guys go. The Nike Kobe 8 in all its glory. This is my personal favorite Kobe ever. Favorite hoop shoe ever. It just, everything about this shoe is just close to perfect. The fit, the materials, the lockdown, the traction. Everything is just so top-notch on this sneaker. During the time, because maybe I think now there's a couple lighter sneakers than this one, but at the time, this was the lightest sneaker of all time. This shoe came out in 2013, and Adidas had their Crazy Light line, and they were like boasting about it and making a big deal about it. But Nike quietly made this the lightest sneaker ever. It came in at 9.5 ounces, lightest sneaker ever at the time. Pretty sure there's a couple, maybe two or more lighter than this one, but again, just everything on the sneaker, just top notch, dude. It was also a groundbreaking sneaker for the materials that it brought. This is a engineered mesh upper. It contained the foot really, really great, and it was a lightweight supportive material. Let me see if I can try to show you guys. The reason I say supportive, it had these built-in flywire, sort of say, like within the upper, and it just provided great containment for it being so light. You know, if you guys can see through the lines. I got a couple other more colorways. I'll try to show you, but I'm just trying to show you now. I'll show you more. The tongue was great, no lace pressure, anything like that, because the padding in the middle. Again, this is a Kobe 8 system, so you could change the midsole, because that was basically the main point of the sneaker was the midsole. during the time Nike came out, I think with three of them, there was one like two Zoom bags, one in the forefoot. I mean, one in the forefoot, one in the heel, and I believe there was the one with full length Zoom, and then the third one was this one, the Lunar Lawn. That's the Kobe System logo. Those funny commercials with Kanye and what the F are you talking about, Kobe? So getting back to more performance of it, the traction was great. Top five for sure. I know a lot of people are gonna say, "Oh, it's the Kobe 9. Kobe 9 has the greatest," but this one's up there. I believe it's up there as well. The crash pad was great for like when you're coming off a rebound or just running a lot. The heel clip was great. It held your foot down great into the sneaker when lacing them up. You guys can see because it was the lace holes, how it goes back towards the heel clip here. Great, 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 great containment and lockdown on this sneaker. Again, I just can't stop talking great things about the sneaker. The shoe is practically perfect in my opinion, and with the entry mesh, the colorways were endless to do with the sneaker. Like, let me show you guys a couple more. No, not this one. This one will be last. This one is one of my second favorite. The Christmas edition. The Christmas edition was, oh my God, was so sick when he wore on Christmas Day against the Knicks. And he was hooping. He was balling in these. The red laces just pop out so great. A lot of people say that the upper reminds them of the, like, you know, traditional, like, Christmas lights. But the inspiration on this was based off a snake. I don't remember how to say the name of the snake. Rhino viper. I'm sorry if I'm butchering the name, but you guys can find out more on it on my Instagram sneaker page, HardSole10. Again, one of my favorites. The design in the back was supposed to be the Kobe logo. They sold, during the time, they sold socks with it, a low-cut socks that would have, like, the other piece of it that was going up. So, it was a cool design at the time. Just more views on it. Again, I try to wear them as much as I can because, like, you know, I don't want sole separation because I have a friend at the gym that recently, he has the elite version and his sole separated, which is crazy because I never really seen that with the Kobe 8. With people that were playing like really, really rugged and hard in their sneakers in the Kobe 8, you know, they would usually get like cuts right here. That's what happened to my younger brother's pair. And then like a few other people would break like the heel clip. But I've never seen sole separation. That's crazy. So I try my best to still wear these to hoop in or casually. I just want to keep these for a very, very long time as much as I can. But is the snake around the logo? I don't know if you guys can see that. Then I like these two, like the aglets on it, where it's like a gray color. Again, just a great, great, great looking sneaker. This sneaker had a bunch of endless fire colorway. Literally, almost all of them sold out. Like the Easters, the All Stars, the Milk Snakes. What else? There's the Valentine's Day. There's a bunch of endless ones. The Sparks, the What Does, a bunch of crazy ones, man. This is really, this one, the Kobe 6, 7, and 8 had the greatest colorways on these sneakers. But there you guys go. And then this one is I'm not too sure what I'm gonna do with these pair, because this one I try to customize it a bit, sort of say. This one is a second edition Christmas colorway one. For anyone that doesn't know, well, I mean, you should know, it was a big news and stuff like that. Kobe tore his Achilles in the sneaker, in the elite version. He tore his Achilles, and it took a while for them to make the Kobe 9. It was almost another year wait for them traditionally how they release and unveil sneakers. So, again, going back to my Instagram sneaker page, I have sample pictures of, well, not really samples. He wore them recovering. Kobe wore like a mid-cut sizing of this shoe to help him recover from his Achilles injury. So we also got also another version 2s of the sneaker. This is a version 2 of the Christmas shoe, and there's a version 2 of the Black History Month shoes. So going to this one was a Christmas snakeskin. It did come with this print on the upper, but I tore it off because it was yellowing, and I didn't really like that look on it. I have played with the snakeskin on it. It does make the foot a little bit more hot. Inside it's very nasty. I would recommend getting rid of it as soon as possible because it does make the foot a little, it does make the shoe a little bit more heavier, and it makes your foot a lot more sweaty you're playing in. So this is what it kind of looked like trying out putting it together. This is what it looked like with the second skin on. I tore it off because I saw like a lot of designs, and I was really interested in it. A lot of people were kind of like, you know, taking the Nike swoosh off and putting it on there. I was thinking about like maybe putting it on the toe because that was the sample, what the sample looked like. It was on the toe. They've also made a soccer colorway of this sneaker too, the Mamba Curio, big popular shoe. I'm thinking about it. Still thinking about it, but I was also kind of like thinking not to get a little bit too hype beast on it, but maybe like a Travis, like a Travis Kobe collab. Just saying, you know, just messing around with it. But then again, this is this version 2 of the Christmas shoe. I really love this like blurred Mamba skin look. Really, really great. Great print. I love it. And then it was a gold Kobe Shizuoka logo in the back. And then if you really kind of look into it deeply, like you can see like the scales on it as well. I really love the heel clip with the Kobe green signature on it. Just really, really, really love this sneaker. Getting back more into it from the welded in like somewhat flywire lines. Well, like it mimicked flywire, and you can kind of see my thumb through it a bit. Just trying to show you guys more views on it. And then the gold Kobe sheath logo on it, and the KB24. Again with the lunar insole. Just really great for its time. This one is perfect. The Kobe 9 was, again, if you saw my other videos, the Kobe 9 was a lot more bulkier, more fatter. Oh yeah, more snake skin on it. You guys can see it there. Traction, again, perfect. Again, I don't know what I really want to do with this, but I need to because I want to wear it. Again, going back to it, maybe a Travis collab. Just kidding, I'm not gonna do that. I saw a gold swoosh on it. It's on Google. There's like a gold swoosh design on it. I'm probably gonna go with that one. But just going back to my opinion, my thought on it, I think greatest basketball shoe ever made. And getting more detailed into this one too, to this colorway. This one, again, it's a Christmas sneaker. It came with hang tags or like locks on the shoe. It also mimics like a ornament. There you guys go. an ornament. The aglets on these are green tips. And then it also came with extra laces with the gold on it. Might switch them. Might have to do that. But then again, guys, best, greatest basketball sneaker ever. Ever. No debate. This one's, oh my, I think that to me, this one's the best color because of the graffiti colorway. This gray and black and like kind of lime green in it. This one of my favorites. Again, when he wore this shoe, statistically, this was his best season years with numbers. He was taught, he had a season high, I believe, in assists and rebounds as well. He was leading the league with scoring too, 34 points at age 34 too. So just a big Kobe fanatic and in love with the sneaker line, and greatest sneaker line ever, greatest performing sneaker line ever. So tell me what you guys think. Tell me what your guys' favorite color, or tell me what you guys think is the best Kobe ever. I mean, I'm probably gonna say no. I'm probably gonna say no to it because this one's just the best. But just let me know which one you guys do you think is your favorite, is the best, and what's your favorite. Again, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you for the view. Thank you for the time to look and discuss with me about shoes and sneakers and stuff like that. Got a couple more coming. Just be patient. I'm doing the best I can to try to get it as quick as I can. Other than that, guys, thanks. Have a good day. Good night. Have a good rest of your day. So, peace.